Hello and welcome back to the St. Mary's Field Museum. We've had a chance now to fully fit out our space here, and we've got displays and we've got some objects from the excavation. And in a future film, we're going to be able to give you a virtual tour of everything that we've got on display here and show you a little bit about what we're doing in the Field Museum. In this film, we're going to be talking about osteology, which is the study of the human skeletal remains. And we're going to introduce you to some of the experts that we've got on the team, and they're going to tell you a little bit about the work that they're doing.
Excavations on rural cemeteries are relatively rare. And while we have a lot of information on urban burial grounds, perhaps we don't have as much as we'd like to have on rural communities in the medieval and post-medieval periods. And I think Stoke Mandeville is going to fill a gap here. It's basically a rural settlement. It's a long-standing rural settlement, and we have continuity of occupation over perhaps 800 years. So not only are we going to learn more about the inhabitants in the past from Stoke Mandeville, but we're going to learn how their lives changed and how their health changed over quite a long period of time, and really build up a picture of what it was to live in the rural environment in those days. We have lots of people over at the church on site at the moment excavating skeletons from the churchyard at St. Mary's, and once the skeletons are recorded, photographed, planned and lifted, they're put into crates and they're sent over to our area over here where we carry out the processing.
Currently we are halfway through our excavations on the graveyard of St. Mary's. We excavated around 1,500 individuals, and 800 of those we have now processed and assessed. We can now say that we had a good balance between males and females, and we are finding a variety of different pathologies that are giving us insights in what age these individuals were at their death, and also what type of diseases they suffered, or like occupational problems that can arise in such a rural community. It is very interesting to see some vitamin deficiencies, such as rickets, affect children in the rural area, especially if we consider that they spend a lot of time outdoors. It is also very interesting to observe a lot of fractures and to conclude a lot of accidents happened, and just to get the whole grasp of life during this period that we are currently studying.
One of the more interesting individuals that we found here had numerous buttons, and also the individual had this curious object by the right side of its head. This was a gentleman who was buried sometime probably in the 18th century, who was probably buried with their wig. And this is because they had what they call a flea trap next to the head. This was a strange object made of bone or ivory, and basically it would be filled up with honey, and the idea was that the fleas in the wig, instead of staying in the wig, would jump out of the wig into the flea trap and they'd get rid of their flea problem. Another interesting thing about this same individual was that we noticed that there were certain holes or lesions in the vertebral column. And this turned out to be a suspected case of brucellosis, which is a disease that you see very rarely in bone. And it's a very interesting find for us because we wanted to see what level of this infectious disease was present in Stoke Mandeville at this time. So that's going to be another interesting skeleton to study here at Stoke Mandeville.
We are hoping that by the end we will be able to say much more about Stoke Mandeville, and also about the differences between the populations that lived in different periods. in this area.